Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to solve exercise 1.11 of our textbook, first course in probability. So in this problem, we have six books, three novels, two mathematics books, and one chemistry book. And the goal is to look at the number of ways you can order them on a bookshelf. In the first question, there is no restriction. In the second question, we assume basically that books in the same topic must be together. And in a third question, we assume that only the novels must be together. So this problem is very similar to a previous problem I solved about the three boys and three girls that must sit in a row. But this problem is a better illustration of the tricks I gave you in this previous video, in the sense that now instead of having two groups of the same size, three boys and three girls, in which case you can still do the counting sequentially. Now we have instead three groups of different sizes, 3, 2, 1, and the tricks I gave you in the previous video will need to be used in this case to solve this problem with the six books. So I just remind you that we have three novels, two math books, and one chemistry book. So in the first question, the goal is to find the number of ways you can order those books on a bookshelf. That's basically an example of permutation. Obviously, we are going to assume that those six books are all six different. You don't have repetition of the same novel or repetition of the same math book. And so for the first question, the total number of possible permutations of those books is just equal again to 6 factorial. So 6 factorial, and that's equal to 720. So now, second question, we assume that the novels must be together and the two math books must be together. So basically, books of the same topic must be together and form a group, a block. So in this case, I'm going to use the same trick as what I used for the, again, previous problem about boys and girls. That was, I think, problem 1.7. And in this case, you are going just to write that, well, let's call those novels, novel 1, 2, 3. And then you have math number 1, math number 2, and chemistry. I'm just going to put a 1, even if you have only one book. Now, the restriction is that, so maybe to illustrate this, you see now that if I indeed draw a line with like six possible positions, then for the first position, I'm already stuck because I have three groups of different sizes. For the first position, well, you may argue that for the first position, you have six possibilities. But if you choose a novel at the first place, then you have two possibilities for the second place. Well, if you choose a math book for the first place, you have only one possibility for the second place. Well, if you choose the chemistry book at the first place, then you have all five here possible books for the second place. And so you see that already here, things become messy if you don't use the trick I gave you in the previous video about problem 1.7. So the trick again, I remind you what it is. Here we want to have all three novels together, the two math books together, the chemistry book, whatever, because that's only one book. And so you are going to draw this picture where you exhibit those blocks that must be together. And the total number of possible permutations such that the three novels are together and the two math books are together is exactly equal to the number of possible permutations of those three groups of books times the number of possible permutations of the books within their group. Okay? And you do that for each topic. And so eventually, you are going to get that in this case, the number of possible permutations is going to be equal to 3 factorial. The 3 comes from the fact that we have 3 blocks with 3 topics. So first, you look at the number of possible permutations of those 3 blocks. And then you are going to look at the number of possible permutations of the 3 novels within this block. You have, again, 3 factorial. For the math book, you have 2 factorial, and for the chemistry book, you have one factorial. So now, if you extend that number and you compute this explicitly, you are going to find exactly 72 possibilities. So there are 72 possible ways to order those six books on a bookshelf in such a way that the three novels are together and the two math books are together. Then, question C, well, that's the same thing, except that now we assume that only the novels must be together and those three books can be at any position. So in this case, you are going to draw again the same picture, N1, N2, N3. Then for the math book, you have book N1, book N2, and the chemistry book is C1. Now, your blocks are different. Instead of having three blocks, you are going to have four blocks. You have a block with the three novels, a block with just one math book, another block with only one the other math book, and a block with the chemistry book. So eventually, you get this kind of partition of the books. You want the books to be basically those three ones together, but those three other books are like, you know, I mean, can be at any position. They are kind of independent. And so now you end up using the same reasoning with, instead of a three factorial, first you are going to order those four different blocks. You have four factorial possibilities. That's 24. So four factorial. And then you still need to order each book, I mean, the books in each of their group. So here you are going to have a three factorial coming from the three novels. And then here, even if this is equal to one, I'm still going to write a one factorial times one factorial times one factorial so that you see the pattern. So one factorial times one factorial times one factorial. So now again, here, or again, if you go back to a previous video, the one about prime 1.7, you will see that we start with a three factorial, four factorial, that's number of groups, factorial, and then followed by a product of factorials where each number corresponds to the number of elements in each group. And if you compute this number explicitly, you are going to find 144. So that's the number of ways, 144. You can order those six books in such a way that only the three novels are together and no restriction on the other books.